first suite in G major for solo cello, played by Yo-Yo Ma here at the Proms, live on Radio 3. Yo-Yo Ma turning to every corner of the Royal Albert Hall after the first of the complete cycle of six cello suites that he's playing for us this evening. Asking if we want to hear more, yes we do. Number two in D minor.
Mm-hmm.
Yo-Yo Ma with Bach's second suite for solo cello in D minor. In rehearsal this afternoon, Yo-Yo Ma said that he wanted to create the intimate atmosphere of a living room so that he could connect with everyone as much as possible in their own rabbit hole. There's a tremendous sense of relaxation and generosity in these performances. It's an epic feat that he's attempting tonight, playing all six in a row, but it's intimate somehow as well. Number three in C major now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bach's Third Suite for solo cello in C major at the Proms, performed by Yo-Yo Ma here at the Roll Up, a whole live on BBC Radio 3. Yo-Yo Ma almost applauding the audience back for this ovation. There's a huge sense of communion between him and this audience as he salutes the people standing at the top of the gallery, turns to everyone in the choir stalls, waves to everyone, seeming wanting to make eye contact with as many people as he can in this sold-out Roll Up hall. Yo-Yo Ma signals that he's got three more to do, so he's now taking a short break before we hear the fourth and fifth and sixth suites for solo cello. So let's use this opportunity to hear from Yo-Yo Ma himself. I spoke to Yo-Yo Ma during his rehearsal earlier today at the Royal Albert Hall, and he told me about the almost impossible demands that these pieces make on him.
To me, one of the great lessons of playing them that I get from looking at these suites or studying them is that Bach was actually trying to do something that was impossible to do, which is that he's writing music for a bowed instrument which usually plays one line at a time, and he's trying to write music with many lines, you know, polyphonically. And how do you do that? And therein lies sort of the mystery, and I think he solves it by not only by virtuosic writing. For example, he would suggest a note in the bass line, and then he'll kind of complete it 7 seconds later after the cello is doing other things. And guess what he uses? He's using the listener's ear to help complete it. So it's like the power of suggestion. I might say something, and in the middle of this, you're going to complete the thought while I come in with new thoughts. And I think this is something that he does magnificently, which is, I think, kind of unprecedented. And up until today, I think very few people have had this kind of ability to do this in the same way that Bach has in the past.
Yo-Yo Ma talking to me earlier this afternoon, and he had more to say about the sense of how we're involved as listeners in this performance, as he told me.
One of the reasons I've played these Bach suites so much is that I think they do have a very powerful effect that's encoded in the music. For some reason, this music, more than almost any other piece, seems to elicit or give to the listener some kind of response that is helpful going through tough times. I've had more letters from children, from adults, when people just say, I was going through this operation, I was just things were really tough. This music was really helpful. So I'm really grateful to have the opportunity to actually play this music live, but also now on radio, because maybe this music can be helpful to people that are going through hard times. I think part of what I was trying to express in terms of asking the listener to help complete something is actually not only a psychological device that Bach uses, but because it requires someone to participate, it reaches inside in obviously an unconscious way. There are no instructions on what you're supposed to do. But I think unconsciously, you do complete it, and as a result, you feel part of a greater whole.
Yo-Yo Ma, well, that greater whole is something he's creating right now in this performance of all six cello suites here at the Proms. But Yo-Yo Ma also told me about that all the movements in all of the suites, it's the sarabands that each suite has, the still slow center of each suite, that has a particular resonance for Yo-Yo Ma.
The saraband, I think, was a dance danced by Bedouin women in North Africa. And it arrived in Spain and was banned because people thought it was too erotic, too lascivious. And so we should have listeners beware. If you don't want to participate in listening, just turn off your radio for the saraband. And 7 minutes later, you can turn it back on. So it was banned. And what happens when things get banned? It moves somewhere else. It went to South America, and it went to France. And the French, of course, like to make things very courtly. And the way we hear the sarabande in the sweets version is as a courtly dance. But in many ways, the heart of the music of each suite is in the sarabande.
Yo-Yo Ma, that's a fascinating idea, the way that one of the forms of the dances that Bach uses in each of these cello suites is in a way connected to other traditions of world music, so that they literally spin out into other aspects of the world. I mentioned earlier the sense about all of these, the experience of the journey going through all six of them as we are this evening, that almost creating a whole world from the cello, from the solo instrument. Well, in a certain sense, that's true, not just from what Bach was doing as a composer of instrumental music in the 1720s in Curtin, but actually the music has already a wider resonance built into the fabric and the structures of what the dancers are, their histories and where they've come from. This concert, although it's an epic feat for Yo-Yo Ma this evening, as he's backstage preparing himself to come out again and play the fourth, fifth, and sixth suites, is only part of his life's journey with this music, though. He started playing them when he was four, learning two bars a day. When he was still in Paris, the family moved to New York, or moved to the United States when Yo-Yo Ma was five. So they've been part of his life for more than five and a half decades. He's recorded them twice, and he made films that accompany his last recorded survey of them as well. He's also been recently playing them in Salzburg, although not all six at the Salzburg Festival, only four. And he described how the idea of being able to play all six to the promenaders and for everyone on Radio 3 was in a way an early 60th birthday present to himself, because he turned 60 in early October. But it feels rather more that the present is rather the other way around, that he's giving us it's an incredible generosity of present to be able to give himself, but really to give us through this performance this evening. It's an extraordinary thought that this music, such an icon of the cello repertoire, and indeed not just the cello repertoire, because every other instrument that's able to that has a similar range of the cello has wanted to try and play this music, everything from tubas to guitars. But the music was really rediscovered for the modern age by Pablo Casals in 1890 as a 13-year-old, when he came across a copy of the suites in a second-hand music shop. Before then, throughout the 19th century, they've been thought of really as didactive music, as exercises. Some exercises. They test, of course, the virtuosity of the player, as we're hearing this evening, and as Yo-Yo Ma told me, was especially true for the music that we're about to hear in the fourth, fifth, and sixth suites. But really, it's a poetic and technical virtuosity as well. And something we're involved in as well. It's a virtuoso exercise for us as listeners, as he says, for us to participate in the performance that Yo-Yo Ma is creating this evening. One of the impossibilities to listen out for in between the fourth and fifth suite is the scordatura. Yo-Yo Ma will detune his A string to turn it into a G string between the fourth suite in E flat major and the fifth suite in C minor. And we'll go back to the conventional tuning of the cello for the sixth suite in D major. But here he is on stage now, accepting this huge ovation at the halfway stage. Smiles, generosity, another salute to this packed rollout of a whole audience, as he prepares for the second half of this Odyssey through Bach's cello suites, the suite number 4 in E-flat major, Yo-Yo Ma at the Proms.
Thank you.
Mars. Suite for solo cello number 4 in E flat major.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yo-Yo Ma of the Proms. Bach's fifth suite for solo cello, the one in C minor. And for such an extrovert performer, the way he's able to create such a... the dark pearl of that music, the intimacy, the introversion, even the grief, the intensity that he comes with in that performance of the second minor key suite of the six. But now there is only one suite left, as your mind indicates to the audience too. The final last little round of applause to give himself energy, and all of us too, to join together in what will be the final cello suite tonight, the last of the six that Johann Sebastian Bach wrote. Yo-Yo Ma applauding himself, applauding the audience, applauding everyone for this collective experience that he's created. So, the sixth and last suite for solo cello in D major, Yo-Yo Ma. Thank you. A spontaneous standing ovation for Yo-Yo Ma's performance of all six of Johann Sebastian Bach's suites for solo and cello here at the Proms. A deep bow to this audience. Everyone is on their feet here, not just the 1,800 Prommers, but everyone in the gallery, in the stalls, everyone around the Royal Albert Halls. Yo-Yo Ma waves to as many members of his audience as he can. That ending just seems to dance into the infinite with energy and with the collective focus that Yo-Yo Ma and this sold-out audience here at the Royal Albert Hall have created, and all of you listening at home and wherever you are too. Those pieces, all of them so totally different, and that the sixth suite opens up another world. So much of it is in the highest register of the cello that the other five suites just haven't used at all. We're in another realm as Yo-Yo Ma comes back on stage here without his cello. Extends his arms and applauds just as wildly as this audience are too. Yo-Yo Ma talked about building a greater whole from that musical journey, but it was a greater whole not just from the suite of all, hearing all six of those pieces, those planets of music joined together, but also the community of joy that he created here and that I'm sure you experienced at home as well. Well, that's all from us here at the Royal Albert Hall tonight. We're back tomorrow with the BBC Concert Orchestra and Karl Orff's Carmina Burana with Saint-Saëns and a world premiere from Guy Barker. But now, as Yo-Yo Ma waves to the audience, who are still cheering, and he leaves the stage, it's time to hand you back to Broadcasting House and to John Shea.
Thank you very much, Tom Service. What an evening. Usually the biggest occasions at the Proms involve the largest numbers of performers on stage. Isn't it strange how sometimes the opposite can be the case? Well, as I'm sure you know by now, all of our Proms are available for you to listen to via the Proms website for 30 days after broadcast. So if my maths is correct, you could listen to that whole concert five times over by taking them one a day. You don't have to listen to all six of the suites at once, of course. You could do a lot worse.
Cuộc sống xa nhà vất vả nẻ ơi, nhiều khi con thấy cuộc đời trôi vơi, bao năm con đi làm xa, sông nơi đất khách xa lạ, tượng trưng gục ngã mẹ. Ở quê thế nào bố mẹ khỏe không? Nghe bạn con nói mẹ già nhiều đi, con cũng nhớ mẹ nhiều lắm, cố sang năm con sẽ về, đều quê ít hôm bên mẹ. Sống tha hương có nhiều đêm xót thương, phải cố mưu sinh cho ngày sau đỡ khổ, con cũng quen rồi mẹ đừng lo nhé, bố mẹ ở nhà giữ gìn sức khỏe. Nhiều lúc con cũng rất buồn tủi thân, nhưng con sẽ cố làm mẹ được vui. Bon chen cũng vì cuộc sống, kiếm cơm đất khách xứ người, nhiều khi khó lắm mẹ ơi. Thank you. xa nhà vất vả mẹ ơi. Nhiều khi con thấy cuộc đời chơi vơi, bao năm con đi làm xa, sống nơi đất khách xa lạ, tựa chừng gục ngã mẹ. Ở quê thế nào bố mẹ khỏe không? Cũng rất buồn tủi thân, nhưng con sẽ cố làm mẹ được vui. Bon chen cũng vì cuộc sống, kiếm cơm đất khách xứ người, nhiều khi khó lắm. Chen cũng vì cuộc sống, kiếm cơm đất khách xứ người, nhiều khi khó lắm mẹ ơi.